Warning, I will not be held responsible for any damages to methods shown in this video may cause to yours or someone else's hardware, including loss of use of such devices and or loss of profits from the resulting inability to use such devices. Any information you choose to put into use from this video is done at your own risk. If your Google TV Chromecast is connected to the internet, you will undoubtedly have noticed that the Google TV Chromecast tends to promote, if not advertise, streaming services that are often pay streaming services, that are often streaming services that you are not subscribed to. The problem with these promotions is if you're setting up a Google TV Chromecast for somebody who's not technologically savvy, they could fall into the traps and pitfalls of downloading and installing these services, starting the free trial, and then getting roped in into subscribing for these streaming services. The goal of this video is to aim to show you how to diminish the exposure to these promotions, as well as to disable the ability to download and install apps on your Google TV Chromecast. So, in the Google TV Chromecast interface, in the upper right corner, if you move your cursor up here, you have settings. You're going to select settings. Under settings, you're going to scroll till you see accounts and sign in. You're going to select that. Under accounts and sign in, you're going to select your account. When your account is up, you're going to scroll down to apps only mode and you're going to select it. Enable apps only mode. This will hide Google's recommendations from your home screen, along with your ability to give feedback on movies or shows or add them to your watch list. Previously purchased titles from Google Play will not be accessible but can be cast from your phone from the Google TV or YouTube mobile app. You can access all of the apps installed on the device and non-personalized featured content will still be shown on the home screen. Search and Google Assistant will be disabled in this mode. Apps can continue to show personally, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so there you go. That's what apps only mode does. Essentially, it changes this interface to this interface. As you can tell, it's simpler. You don't have search for you, movies, shows, Google TV, library. You don't have any of that. You have home. The problem is that Google, you know, they wanted that promotion in there, boy. Did they ever. So, even in apps-only mode, there's still this scrolling banner, this huge scrolling banner, which takes up 80% of the screen. And what does it suggest? Streaming, paid streaming services that you do not subscribe to. Of course, this still leaves the possible pitfall of clicking on, for example, in this case, watch on Disney Plus, which downloads and installs the app and then tries to coerce you into getting the free trial, which will then turn into a paid subscription service. What can we do to fix this? Remember, in the upper right corner, you have settings. You're going to go into settings. This time around, you're going to scroll down to apps. You're going to select apps. Under apps, you're going to select see all apps. Under all apps, you're going to scroll down to show system apps. You're going to select that. Under all apps, system apps, you're going to find Google Play Store. You're going to select Google Play Store. Under Google Play Store, you have the option to disable. Google Play Store, disable. Do you want to disable this app? The answer is okay. At which point, you'll be returned to your standard apps-only mode interface with the 80% of the screen promotional banner. What happens now that you've disabled the Google Play Store is that should the user select Watch On, one of the suggestions, if the app is not downloaded to the Google TV Chromecast, it will perform no action. Furthermore, if you have service-specific buttons, for example, on my Canadian remote, I have a YouTube button and I have a Netflix button. if the Netflix app is not installed to your Google TV Chromecast, and if the YouTube app is not installed to your Google TV Chromecast, pressing these buttons just make a sound on the screen, but it does not automatically go to the Google Play Store, inviting you to download, install, and subsequently jump through the hoops to become subscribed. Well, there you go. Before I leave you, how we went into these all apps and disabled Google Play Store. Oh, I should mention, if ever you want to add an app to your Google TV Chromecast, you can follow the exact same steps, essentially, upper right, settings, apps, see all apps. And at the top, you have disabled apps. If you don't see the app you want, you could show system apps. You could find Google Play Store, and which point, when you select it, instead of selecting disable, you'll be able to enable and use the Google Play Store again. Before I let you go, very important that you don't play too much in these all apps. Yes, a lot of things you can disable. If you don't quite know what the service is, or the app is, don't disable it. I essentially got stuck in a boot loop doing so, where essentially the Google TV Chromecast would no longer boot, and I had to go through a arduous process in order to factory data reset it. So it's not recommended that you play too much in this section. However, I can attest that disabling the Google Play Store is doable, and furthermore, re-enabling the Google Play Store to subsequently add apps to your Google TV Chromecast afterwards is doable. It works for me. Again, all of this is at your own risks and perils. There you go. I'll leave you with this. I hope this information helps, and as usual, all the best.